What's up, my pilots? Angry Poncho here, and we are back playing Fallout New Vegas. In this episode, we are going to continue exploring the Repcon Research Labs.
All right, Smoothskin, I'm letting you in. You better watch yourself. I'll sure as hell be watching you.
Ghouls always have such nasty voices. They got that,
God, but are you ugly. Get upstairs and talk to Jason before I throw up just from looking at you.
What the hell are you talking about? You're not even a ghoul.
Your pranks won't work on me, Smoothskin. They won't work on Jason either.
Jason? Yeah.
Good riddance.
Anyway, let's go find this Jason guy. Apparently he's in charge around here. Oh, hello. That's not where I want to go. Upstairs. Hello? No. You look important.
Hello, Wanderer. Please forgive us our humble surroundings. Our true home awaits us in the far beyond.
What?
Have you come to help us complete the great journey?
What? I came here because feral ghouls have been wandering into Novak.
And they've been shooting them down like animals, haven't they? Those ghouls were members of my flock, even after the madness consumed their minds. We never let them wander free. We kept them safe on the first floor. We kept them contained. The demons must have let them out. Somehow. And now they are lost forever, denied the salvation and healing glow of the far beyond. Please, Wanderer, bear in mind that every feral ghoul you spare now is one that we can save later.
What?
Once the way is clear, our feral brothers and sisters will accompany us on the great journey. If there are any left.
There aren't any left, but let's not tell Jason that. Great journey?
We wish to escape the barbarity of the wasteland, especially the violence and bigotry of its human inhabitants. The Creator has promised to my flock a new land, a place of safety and healing, a paradise in the far beyond. Preparations for the great journey were nearly complete when the demons appeared.
Demons?
The demons appeared from nowhere. Except it might be more accurate to say they never actually appeared at all. The demons are invisible. Where one of them stands, the most one sees is the air shimmering like sunlight on water.
Like a stealth boy.
They set upon us as we were on our way to worship one morning. We had just entered the basement. My flock fought bravely and killed a few, but at such cost. Nearly half of us died or went missing. The rest of us retreated up here. One of the demons raved at us, but they have not tried to attack us since. Still, their demonic presence brought all progress towards the great journey to a standstill. But now you have come. Once again, the Creator has sent a human to help us across a seemingly insurmountable obstacle.
Oh, you have so much text, Jason. So much dialogue. One of these demons raved at you?
Yes, over the intercom. Threats of death should be step outside. Guarantees of safety should be stay locked away. It went on for hours, and did not always make sense. But that was the first day only. Since then, silence. Will you drive away the demons, Wanderer?
Yeah, I'm down for it.
Praise the Creator! Bless you, Wanderer! Bless us all! As soon as the underground has been rid of demons, preparations for the great journey can resume.
Alright. I think that he's wearing like a blazer and slacks. But I've never seen one that torn up before, but still being worn. Kind of funny, actually. Anyway, I guess it suits his character. Being a glowing one ghoul and all that. Let's head on downstairs. We're gonna go ahead and clear the basement away, too. I don't have a whole lot of sympathy toward super mutants in general. Nightkin, in particular, just tend to be insane. To the point where a lot of the time there's just no reasoning with them. Now, in this quest, you actually can reason with the head Nightkin. The difficulty is, even after you do, a lot of his followers are still, What do you call it? I do not want that human flesh. Oh my goodness. A lot of his followers are still hostile towards you, so there's really no point. It's kind of weird and glitchy, and I think it's easier just to kill them all. More fun, too. And I don't have to mess around with any stealth nonsense. We all know I'm not any good at that stuff. I have to just watch out for anything shimmering in the air. Now, I think it's Edie that allows us to target cloaked opponents in vats. Ugh. Okay, apparently we're still going to target Veronica instead. Here we go. You're a nightkin. Stab, stab, stab. Veronica does a lot of damage. Look at that. Look at that knockdown. Stab him in the face. It seems like sometimes Edie plays a slightly sped up version of his combat music. Ah, knockdown on the first blow. Bad luck for you, Nightkin. That's a perfect kill for me. I'm gonna search all of them in case they have stealth boys, but I am not interested in that rebar club weapon. It's not particularly useful. Hello. Look at all this garbage back here. A lot of scrap metal and stuff. Yeah, there's nothing I want here. Let's continue. Oh my goodness gracious. He scared me. Veronica is punching limbs off of most of the opponents we run into. That's pretty awesome. Let's see. What was I doing? Yes. Fixing my crippled head. That's right. That actually scared the crap out of me. I'm astounded that Veronica is having such an easy time with them. Yeah, the difficulty's still on very hard. Okay. Cool. Veronica's just that much of a badass, I guess. There you are. Man, the odds of me hitting him that many times without getting a knockdown are pretty low. Often if you get in there, I should figure out what's the 50-50 point in terms of number of blows that you have to throw in order for it to be more likely than not that you get a knockdown on a 15% chance of each hit. Not entirely sure.
Antler says you are the one killing my kin. Antler says you must die.
All right. You're hey, not. Antler. Fuck you. Oh, Davison, you fell down. I love the sound that her ballistic fist makes. That just makes me so happy. She's punchy. Davison's key bumper sword. Not really interested. Actually, is that valuable enough worth taking? Eh, not really. This Davison's key open. Oh, that's not how I expected that to open, but okay. Oh, it does that. Why is there an electrical switch if I can do that manually? Alright, we're done down here. Anyway, we got Davidson's key, so I think now we need to work our way to the other side of the basement. I'm not exactly sure where I need to be using Davidson's key, but I'm sure we'll find it before too long. Ah, this one.
Come and get it, you big dumb. Hey, you're not one of those things out there. Who the hell are you?
Jason sent me.
And I bet he told you it's the creator's will for you to risk your ass instead of him, right? Well, good luck with that. I'd give you a hand, but no thanks. I may look like a corpse, but I'm partial to living.
Oh. You don't look like the other ghouls from Bright's group.
Guess the outfit gives that away, huh? I never did buy into that religious mumbo-jumbo with the robes and all that shit. It gets lonely out in the wastes, okay? And I don't have to tell you. That Bright's group has got some fine-looking ghoulettes in it. Huh. Or maybe I would have to tell you.
I hadn't.
Anyway, I helped them out, and they kept me supplied with ammo and pleasant company.
I did not realize that any of those ghouls were females. It's just hard to tell, I guess, with the dead skin and no hair. I don't know. Can I help you down from here? What, you wanna go?
Huh. Well, you're polite. I'll give you that. If this was just between you and me, I'd do as you ask. But it's not. I had a friend with me when those mutant bastards came out of nowheres. She panicked and ran the wrong direction. Further into the basement. She's probably dead. But I ain't leaving until I know for sure. I'd have gone looking myself, except I wouldn't last a minute out there. You, on the other hand, seem pretty resourceful. Find my friend, and I'll get out of your way.
Okay.
Thanks. Let me know what you find out. Here's hoping she's okay.
Yeah, unlikely. Anyway, it's a bit weird to me that Harlan says to you something about, oh yeah, I bet Jason asked you to go risk your ass in his place, huh? Whoa, you know, kind of implying like, I would never do that. What a coward Jason is. And then he's like, well, I guess I could ask this other guy to go and look for my girlfriend, so I don't have to do it. Oh, Harlan the hypocrite. Should have another nice Nightkin fight in here. I think this guy likes to carry an incinerator, if I remember correctly. I seem to recall that from a long time ago. Nightkin Jailer! Oh, you dropped your incinerator! Oh, you fell down! Oh.
I'm gonna need some new limb.
Oh, crap. Did I hit Veronica and cripple a limb? Yeah, she's fine. Jail key. I'll take the flamer fuel. Why not? Incinerator. What's back here? I'm amazed that there was no skill book in this entire area. Honestly, I'm not finding a whole lot of valuable loot at all. Really just a lot of nothing. Let's see. Where's the way to go down here? Is there a staircase or something? This might be it. I could just jump down, but I need to find the way back up anyway, so might as well explore a little here. Ah! Very, very nice. Are those? I guess they have some kind of randomization algorithm for the papers that are strewn about on the floor. Unlock the jail key. Nice. Hello? Hello? Anyone down here? Harlan's friend. Are you here? I heard you're a fine-looking ghoulette. Oh, there's more. I'll check those on the way out. Arrow? Oh, radioactive barrels. Actually, just regular old barrels. Oh, damn. Oh, she is a... Hang on. Can I even... She is a fine-looking ghoulette. Well, she's dead. If that is her, I don't know. How do I know? How do I know which ghoul we're talking about here? I'll just... If there are no survivors, I guess that's that, but still. I have some kind of mark on my compass sending me to a location that's right next to where I am, but I'm not sure what it is. What is... It's sending me right here. Don't know what that is. Let's see. Return to Harlem and let him know the bad news. Report to Jason Bright that the Nightkin are gone. Okay. Maybe another part of the basement is actually directly above us here, so... We'll circle around. It seems like whatever that marker was on, it wasn't on this floor. My hunger level's increased. Is that gonna make me... I'm not over-encumbered. That's good, at least. I think I might have forgotten to check these guys. No more stealth boys. No more free stealth boys, I guess. Oh well. Actually, I think there might be a box behind where Jameson stands. Or Jameson. Davidson. That has some more... Antler. You're funny. Look at this. Ah, there you go. You can be with Davidson. I'm a nice guy. Don't ever say I didn't do nothing for you. After I murdered you. Alright. I don't see any more Nightkin. Oh yeah, the Nightkin were here searching for the shipment of Stealth Boys. But it turned out that shipment was already gone. I don't know. I feel like they probably got all used up in the 200 years intervening.
Did you find my friend?
Bad news, buddy.
I see. Well, spare me the details. Damn it. I'm gonna miss that crooked yellow smile.
Brown chicken pie.
Alright. You did your part, so I'll do mine. Look around up here if you want. I'm gonna make a break for topside.
Funny thing is, I don't know if I really have a good reason to want... to want to go up there. I think Davidson wants you to do something that's you have to be behind Harlan to do, but I don't actually remember what it was now. He's been eating rad roaches. Gross. I know he has some traps planted up here. Oh, he's got some 308 rounds. That's nice. Anything else that I really want? Let's go look over there, shall we? What's this? First aid pack on the wall back there, too. Activate terminal. What do we got? Shipment mistake. Here we go. Blah, blah, blah. Mergers. Shipment sent back. Got it. That's all you need is the title. You don't need to read any more. That email, the title is enough. Ooh, lots of goodies in there. I like to open up one of those and find Rataway and Stim Packs and who knows what else. Alright, what do you say we eat a little something before we head back up? Here we go. Maize. That's good stuff. Pretty light, restores 81 food. Your food meter goes up so slowly that you really don't need to improve it very often. A lot of the food I hang on to is just for its healing capability. The rest of it's not too important. Alrighty then. Now that Harland is buggered off, I don't know, does he actually... I don't think he goes on the Great Journey. Like you said, he doesn't buy into the religious stuff. Does he come back up here where Jason Bright is after you tell him about this, or does he just disappear into the ether? A lot of characters, once their quests end, just poof, they're gone. They don't exist in the world anymore, or they just stand around in the same place forever. I think he might be one of the ones who just disappears. Where you at, Jason? Are you in here? Hello.
Is the way clear?
And bright.
Praise the Creator, and bless you, Wanderer. The way is clear. I will lead my flock through the basement to the sacred site. I hope you will come find us there, Wanderer. There is much to be done.
Okay, here we go. I'm gonna follow you, Jason, if you don't mind. Oh, he's bright, all right. See what I did there? Let me help you out there a little bit, Jason. I'm just gonna push you off to the right here. You wanna... There he goes. Okay. He figured it out. He's a smart one. Just give him... Hello. You guys have rocket suits on. Or something. I like chasing them down to the basement. For some reason, that's more exciting than walking back down there myself. Plus, you have to head that way anyway, so you might as well keep you from getting lost in this basement again. These guys are moving faster than me. They take very efficient routes, too, right around a corner. Oh, he just disappeared. That's bullshit. I'm calling shenanigans. He just teleported away. Or used a stealth boy. Although, they make a sound when you activate them, don't they? He couldn't have just poof disappeared like that. This door should be open, too. They all would have just come through here. Anyway, we don't have to walk through this whole building anymore, because once we come out on the other side here, there will be an exit that goes up to the surface, and we'll be able to come straight down here to the very bottom of the building without having to go through the Repcon HQ above. Nothing valuable in there. We'll just keep on keeping on here. Damn, Veronica, are you kicking the barrels around? Be careful now. What we got here? Reloading bench. Again, no interesting loot to be seen. A little bit of ammo. Okay. I missed this door. Nothing in there. Alright. Didn't miss much. And here we are!
I waited to speak with you one last time before I descended to the launch pad, Wanderer. I want you to know that we will remember for all eternity how you delivered us to the threshold of the Great Journey. Our preparations are nearly complete, but the rockets that will carry us to salvation are yet missing vital components. If you would still help us, Wanderer, speak to Chris. He can tell you what is missing. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always.
Okay, I was sneezing. Are you really going to make a trip on those rockets?
Yes. The rockets will convey us to our promised land in the far beyond. Vision upon vision has confirmed it.
I wonder where they're going to land. I really don't have much confidence in those rockets, Jason.
I understand your concerns, friend, and I thank you for voicing them. But the Creator's will for us has been made manifest.
Alright. So where exactly are you going?
I have glimpsed it only in visions, Wanderer, but what I have seen is truly miraculous. It is a place of light and healing, and I know in my soul that my flock will be safe there.
Sure. Hey, what's the deal with the regular old dude who thinks he's a ghoul?
After all that you have done for us, I suppose you deserve to know everything. When Chris came to us, we tried to convince him that he was human. But this only angered him. He seemed lost. We decided to let him stay with us for a few days, over the course of which we learned that his technical skills far surpassed our own. It became clear that the Creator had sent him to us to ensure the success of the Great Journey.
Just like me, huh?
Equally clear was that Chris should labor in blessed ignorance of his humanity and his inability to make the journey himself. It is no coincidence that two humans have been vital to the success of the Great Journey. It is my belief that the Creator sent you and Chris to expiate the sins of your kind against mine. Your Redeemers both.
Wow. So you're just going to leave him here. You're a jerk.
Such is the Creator's will. Vision upon vision has shown me that were Chris to accompany us, he would die in minutes. The radiation around the launch pad alone would kill Chris in minutes. The radioactivity of the far beyond is much stronger.
Well, it's really none of my business. You misled him.
I take no pleasure in hiding the truth from Chris, but it is the Creator's will to which I must submit.
Okay.
There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always.
Always, always, always. Bye, Jason. Hey. Have fun on the rocket ships. Yes, you look down here. Him and all his other bright followers are running around with rocket ship hats on. I don't know why I can't think of the word spacesuit. My brain keeps coming up with other words. Hey, Chris.
Jason says that I am to cooperate with you on the final tasks necessary to launch the Great Journey.
Are your eyes open right now? Why were they open? What do you do here exactly, Chris?
I'm the flock's resident engineer. I've always been good with machines. Jason says the Great Journey would have been impossible without me. Of course, my skills aren't much use unless I have the right materials. That's where you come in.
Oh, another fetch quest. Hey, why won't they let you down on the launch pad, huh?
When I joined the flock, Jason made it clear that he wanted me to supervise the repairs, not do them myself. It would be a waste of my gifts to work on just one system at a time. From up here, I've been able to supervise the entire project.
That's convenient. It's also because you would die if you went down there.
I thought we were past all that, Smoothskin. But you just can't resist the chance to mess with me. Typical human. I was human once, you know. Grew up in Vault 34, northeast of here. Nice upbringing if you like assault rifles and target practice. But oh, you prefer machines that don't shoot people? Not so nice, then. Who should maintain the vault's reactor? Hauser? Mitchell? No! Make it Haversome. He likes machines. Haversome won't mind getting irradiated. Haversome won't mind mutating. He's already ugly as it is. Haversome won't mind when his hair starts falling out after a few years. There's no connection, Haversome. You're neurotic.
Dude, you're not a ghoul, you're just bald.
Bald? You call this bald, Smoothskin? I'm a monster. A monster!
Dude. Alright, I'm gonna let you in a little bit of a secret here. Jason knows that you are not a ghoul. In fact, everyone here knows. And you are not going on this magical radiation journey.
Oh, God. You're telling me the truth, aren't you? Oh, no. How could they do this to me? For 2 years. My God, I've been a joke to them.
No, they like
you. Do you have any idea how easy it'd be for me to sabotage those rockets? That'd be a joke, huh? One hell of a joke.
Dang, man. Take it easy, dude. You don't need to be killing people.
What, you think I'm too stupid to pull it off? I know enough to get their rockets working, don't I? So I can make them fail, too.
Really? I don't think you're a bad person.
Like I could forgive myself for getting duped like this? They used me, and now they'll throw me away.
Yeah, Chris, they want to take you, but you're human, and this is not going to work.
And dying would be worse than this? Used up and thrown away like garbage?
Dude, you're not dead. They really like you anyway. They think they're going to revere you as a redeemer.
Oh, so I've redeemed the human race, is that it? What a crock. The human race can't stand me.
You're a little bald, but I guess your voice sounds weird, but I think you might be aping that. I'm not sure. You're fine, Chris. I like you all right. I like your tie. Your mustache is kind of mustachey.
So, you want me to accompany you on your adventures across the wasteland, is that it?
Actually, you could go live in Novak. It's pretty close by.
Life among humans again? That's what you're suggesting? I guess it's the only chance I've got. I can't believe I'm agreeing to this, but I'll give it a try. I'll get Jason and his flock on their way, and then I'll head for Novak.
Tell Boone I said hi. Anyway, what do I need for these rockets?
Are you ready to get started? Those rockets aren't going to launch themselves.
Yeah?
I was close to completing work on the rockets before we were driven into hiding on the top floor. 2 components were missing. A quantity of isotope 239 igniting agent, and a set of thrust control modules. The igniting agent is highly radioactive and decays quickly. That's why we can't use the drums that leak down on the launch pad. It's no longer potent enough. I need you to find an intact, shielded container of the igniting agent. As for the thrust control modules, they were custom built for these rockets. They won't even launch without them.
Alright, I'll go look for things.
Alright. Anything else?
I'm going to go look for things.
Later.
I'm also going to take this spacesuit with me. Yeah, spacesuit! Hang on 1 second. Let's put it on. Look at this. Spaceman! Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Alright, let's go and get ourselves some rocket fuel. You can tell Chris which one you're going to go and get first. But I think you actually... Yeah, that just gives you the marker for it. It's not, doesn't matter which one you do. In what order. No big deal. Oh, we're not responding. Oh, and we're here. Good. Mrs. Gibson? Are you here? Old Lady Gibson? I'm here to buy thrust... How are you sleeping through that?
Hi there. I'm Old Lady Gibson, or so they tell me. I've got odds and ends for sale, and I'm pretty good at fixing things, too. You might have noticed the very large building just north of here. That's Helios 1. The NCR runs the place, so it's off limits to prospectors.
Oh. Do your bits and pieces that you have in stock happen to include thrust control modules from Repcon?
As it so happens, I do have some thrust modules, but they're expensive. 500 caps worth of expensive.
Lady, that's a drop in the bucket. Actually... What? Oh, God, I'm going to hit on old Lady Gibson. An attractive woman like yourself, all alone? Maybe you and I could work out some kind of trade.
I know I'm not young and pretty anymore, but I appreciate the thought all the same. Here, take the parts, you flatterer.
Oh.
Download complete. Begin recording.
What?
Navarro Outpost Scientist, I am glad that EDE has reached you. You will find several databanks of information on this machine.
Okay. Edie wants to talk to us.
Please handle this information with the utmost care, as it represents the sum total of the results of my research on the Duraflame iBots. There are also several databanks with information on my research into Poseidon Energy, and some projects they were working on in the Mojave area.
Hmm, cool. Thanks, Edie. Good to know you are full of knowledge, as well as soda. We have to go tell Chris that we got the first component before he'll give us the marker for the next one. And if I can... let's see if I can find the entrance over here. Sort of a manhole in the ground. Yeah, there it is. Hatch to Repcon Basement. This is where you go in to input the numbers once a day. Or however often it is. 4, 8, 15, 16, 23, 42.
Have you found the components we discussed?
Yes.
Indeed you did, and they seem to be in excellent condition. All I need now is the igniting agent we discussed earlier.
I hope you appreciate what I'm doing for you. I had to hit on an old lady.
Bye.
He doesn't appreciate it at all. Now we're gonna go and get atomic fuel for the rockets. Spaceman! I don't know why that's so much fun for me now. Over here, I'm amazed Novak is the closest location we have to Clark Field. This is kind of a funny one, actually, this next location that we're headed towards over here. This is one of the places in the game that has what I guess could be considered a backstory. Or not really, it's not really the backstory in like lore or anything like that. I just mean the location itself tells a little bit of a narrative. And this is kind of a funny one, I think. Let's see if I can find the details for that, as well as grabbing the atomic fuel that's over here. I also think we need to be careful, because this area is filled with some more high-level geckos, if I recall correctly. And they can be a pain in the ass, especially if you're not expecting it. Go ahead and repair Chance's knife to full quality. Hey, I guess this spacesuit is light armor, so I'm able to move pretty quickly. That's cool. Down he goes! Young golden gecko. So sleepy. So you got a guy here, Scavenger. He's got the igniting agent, apparently in a tiny bottle that's open. I don't know. As well as his radiation suit and Mr. Radical's journal. This is kind of a funny one. As you can see, we're getting a lot of radiation right now. I'm actually wearing the spacesuit to increase my rad resistance, which is at 54%. I could have taken Rad-X too, not a big deal. Where is... here we go. Day one. Love the suit. Can scavenge anywhere now. Screw the rads. I hereby christen myself Mr. Radical. Get it? Ha. The suit passed first test with flying yellow colors. Overnight visit to Yucca Mountain. Huh, that's funny. Yucca Mountain. That's where we actually... that's a real location where we dispose of nuclear materials. Didn't go too deep because of something big moving further down the tunnel. I would love if that was a real place in the game. Rad level high even where I was, and it didn't feel a tickle. Go, rad suit, go! Vomited all morning. Didn't splash on suit or I'd be pissed. Must be something I ate. Wow. Exciting. Ran across old woman's scrapyard. Bought a glowing container for measly 50 caps. Heading for Clark Field to prove suit at higher rad levels. If this holds up, I'm gonna go pop this jar of goop open and pour it all over me. I better get swimming this stuff if I had enough of it. Oh yeah! Yeah, and he's dead. He's a real dummy, that guy. But he makes me laugh. Ah. Poor fool, he makes me laugh. Well, I think with that, we now have returned all of the things that they need to launch their rockets and begin the great journey. Exciting, right? We'll go and give this igniting agent to Chris here. Hey, buddy.
Have you found the components we discussed?
I must be in the air, because I'm not normally taller than you.
Yes, that's the stuff. And the container shielding must be intact, or you'd be dead by now.
Oh, thanks. So, we're good to go, right?
Yes. I'll tell Jason that the great journey can begin.
Hooray!
The rockets are ready, Jason. The great journey can begin. Good luck, I guess.
Yeah. And then I think he gives a speech.
Gather all. May the Creator guide my words and help me speak true. The Almighty Creator has seen fit to answer our prayers. The time has come for us to board the rockets and begin the great journey. Though it may seem that all humans despise us, the Creator has seen fit to instruct us differently. The journey ahead would have been impossible if not for the intercession of two human friends, one new, the other a long-abiding companion. To our new friend, we say thanks and promise never to forget how we cleared from our path the demons who sought to stay our journey.
You're welcome.
But to Chris, we owe more than thanks. Chris, you have made this great journey a reality. From this moment forward, you will be remembered as the saint of the great journey. We shall never forget you. I ask that you forgive us, Chris, and give us your blessing. And we bestow ours upon you. Seekers, board the rockets. Take your seats. The great journey awaits.
Oh boy.
To the promised land we go. To the far beyond.
Hey, far, wait. Far away.
Hey.
Bye, Chris.
Hey.
Hey, sprint as fast as sprint away as fast as you can if you're grateful for all I've done for you. Oh, and he stops. You bastard. Wow, what a jerk. Anyway, let's go up to the viewing platform. This is actually on the top floor of the building. You have to run all the way back up there. I'm a little concerned. I wonder if our science skill is going to be high enough for the last piece of this quest. I don't know what our science skill is right now. Let me check. 58. I don't know. It might be close. I think I might need 75 or 55 for the skill check at the end of this quest. Oh well. We'll see. We'll find out when we get there. God, this is a huge basement. I'm so glad they put in that hatch so you don't have to run all the way through here every time you're coming back to deliver something to Chris. Seriously. Take all day. Ah, it's such a long walk from the bottom of the basement where the rockets are. Way up through this entire building, through like three different areas. Still not there, we still have to go through the research labs up here. Head over this way. To the test site! This is like the top floor, so I guess that's the dome where the rockets are over there. Anyway, here on the navigation console, it displays a wealth of information concerning the predicted trajectory of the rockets. Let's examine the data further. Examining the rockets a little further, it looks like the computer is set to make a non-optimal route. You produce surmise that with minor altercations, you can plot a course that will take them closer. Make the change? Make the change. Cool. That was a science check, actually, but it must have been 55, because I got plus 55 experience. Is that all there is to do here? Alright. Without further ado, let's launch the rockets. Whoa, that third one didn't look so good. Hopefully they corrected course once they got up in space or somewhere. People are so happy now. Come fly with me. Follow me. Yeah, follow me. So normally you would hear Wagner's overture, I think, playing there, Ride of the Valkyries. You know that. But I have my radio volume turned down to zero because of all the copyright nonsense that you get with the music in the background of this game. And I'm pretty sure, actually, that leaving that in the video would have been enough to get a flag. So, sorry. You have to be satisfied with my own impression of the music. And these goddamn serpentine hallways again. I can never navigate this freaking building. It seriously is the most confusing interior in the entire game. Such a mess. Alright. And we're back outside. That is all for Come Fly With Me. In the next episode of Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, we are going to head to Helios 1 and do some more sciencey quests. Thanks for watching. See you guys then.